January 1996. Start. Mr. Speaker, I thank you for giving me this opportunity to say a few words on the governor's address this forenoon. The governor has given us an idea of the various measures to be undertaken by government for the welfare of the people of the state. Many important subjects have not been included in it. Nevertheless, it contains information about a few schemes. I want to be brief in my speech. Let me first refer to the public distribution system. I think it is the duty of the government to supply all essential articles through fair price shops at cheap prices so that it may be helpful to the poor people, especially to those who are below the poverty line. No doubt the rich people can pay higher prices for these articles in the open market. But the poor people are now put to lot of difficulties. The government should therefore take such steps as are necessary to supply all essential articles to the poor people at cheap prices through fair price shops. I am glad to know of the schemes introduced for the welfare of the Adi Dravidars. We all know how they have been suffering in the past. Nobody now seems to be sincere in helping them to come up in life. In spite of several years of independence, their conditions have not improved. Every party is interested in getting their votes, so they approach them just before the elections when they promise to do so many good things for them. But after the elections are over and they come to power, they completely forget those people. I am sorry that has been the practice for so long. This state of affairs should not continue. I would now like to refer to the lack of coordination among the various departments of the government. There is the Public Works Department, the Highways Department and the Electricity Department. For carrying out their respective works, each department ticks the roads for laying pipes, cables, etc. After the work is over, they do not care to close the pits and make the road as it was before. So the public and the users of vehicles are put to lot of trouble. This is not a difficult matter. This does not require special skills. If only there is proper coordination and if only they care for the convenience of the public, they can rectify this. It is a matter for great satisfaction that in recent years there is an increase in the number of universities started in this state. In this connection, I would like to point out that the mere increase in their number will not improve the quality of education. Such universities should be provided with the necessary infrastructure. They should have efficient professors, modern laboratories, libraries, etc. Moreover, they should have complete freedom to prescribe courses of study and evaluation of performance of the students. Only then the quality of education will improve. With these words, I conclude my speech. letter from Nelson Engineering Company Limited, Coimbatore to Mrs. Mohan and Company, Salem. Dear Sirs, we are very glad to receive your letter of the 4th instant. We are very much interested in the project referred to in your letter. We have the necessary facilities to undertake the work. We have the equipment, men and materials also. We have undertaken jobs similar to the one that you want us to take up for you in Erode and other places. All of them are satisfied with our performance. We are getting more and more inquiries from those areas. We are sending our engineer, Mr. Vasan, to see you on the 15th instant. He is the person who is in charge of such jobs undertaken by us. He will be in a position to answer any points that you may like to raise in this connection. After seeing the place and the nature of work, he will give you an idea of the approximate amount that we may charge for this job and the time within which the work will be completed. He will offer any advice on any matter. If you want, we assure you of our best services. Yours faithfully, Staff.